Hey everyone! Who's ready to play a game? I know I am. You're about to see several snowmen on the screen. One of these snowmen has a cookie hidden in his top hat. The snowman will then get shuffled up, but your challenge will be to keep your eye on the snowman with the cookie. Think you can do it? If so, let me hear you say, "Oh yeah!" All right, here we go! Okay, shout out 1, 2, or 3 if you think you know which snowman has the cookie. Great job, everyone!
Hi, boys and girls, welcome back to the Game of Life.
Hola, me llamo Eddie.
Oh, Eddie, yes, yes, hi, thank you. Yes, this is my my friend, Eddie, and yeah, we're going to be learning from the game Words with Friends.
Words with Friends.
Uh-huh.
Well, what are we gonna do? Because we need to get you some friends. All right, boys and girls, if you would like to be Pastor Joey's friends, hit the like button.
Well, you set me up perfect for what we're learning today, Eddie, because I'm gonna tell you to watch your mouth.
Watch my what?
Watch your mouth.
What's it gonna
do? You know, that phrase has been uttered by parents and teachers and even children's pastors as we learn and grow up in this thing called life.
Okay, so everyone, boys and girls, open your mouth and have Pastor Joey watch it.
No, no, no. Too often we speak way before we think.
Ah.
Yeah.
Okay.
More often than that, the words that are spoken, they do a lot of damage to others.
Oh, that's right. Our mouths can be very, very powerful.
Yeah, the words are very powerful. The words that come out of there. So in this week's lesson, we're going to learn the destructive power of unhealthy words and how to lift those words with friends from the gutter to the clouds.
So we're going to work on using words properly with our friends.
We'll know how to say nice things.
How to do what?
Be sweet.
What?
Be caring.
Huh?
Be loving.
Because you can.
Eddie, pay attention to this week's lesson.
I didn't know you had a cat.
I don't have a cat.
Then what vomited on your head?
Man, I'm in such a good mood today. Oh, hey, Tracy.
Hey, I heard you lost some weight.
Yeah, I did. Thanks.
Looks like you found it.
And now I'm in a bad mood.
Ah, smell the fresh air.
Ooh, your armpit smells so bad. The teacher gave you an A just to not raise your hand.
Yeah, I'll be right there. Just a second. Can I help you?
Oh, you're so ugly. When you were born, the doctor slapped your mama.
Hey!
It's me, Game Boy!
Wow. Your appearance is almost as scary as your outfit.
That will be enough of that.
Enough of what?
Your mean words.
Hey, I can't help it. It's just the way I am.
I think you can help it. I'll show you.
Ah! Where are we?
My bad.
I know this game, but I have it on an app. This is so old school.
Yes. You see, sometimes we can learn some great lessons from the games that we play. You know, it's important that we are careful about our words with friends.
Be careful? What are you talking about?
Your words are very powerful. Have you ever heard the phrase, "Sticks and stones may break my bones"?
But words will never hurt me. I've heard that before.
Too bad it's not true. Our words are very powerful. You see, when we use words with our friends, our family, or even strangers, those words, they hurt an awful lot. They do a lot of damage.
What does that have to do with me?
A lot. You see, you've been using your words to hurt others, to tear them down, and to do a lot of damage. You need to use your words to help them, to build them up, to make them feel better.
Come on, they're just words, right?
Words are never just words. You see, we gotta use every word to help, not hurt. That's what the Bible teaches us.
Wow, I never really realized how much it hurt when I used mean words with friends. I'll work hard to change that.
Awesome, it looks like you learned your lesson today. And it's time for you to get into your lesson. You're gonna be learning all about words with friends. You're gonna learn some awesome stuff from the Apostle Paul today. This is Game Boy, signing off. Sorry about that. Wrong button.
Let's try another. This one will be a little faster. Whoa, that was fast. Did you keep track of the cookie? If so, shout it out. 1, 2, or 3, if you think you know which snowman has the cookie. Great job, everyone. Let's try another one.
Hey, boys and girls, how many of you have ever heard the phrase, sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will, say it with me, never hurt me? We've all heard this, but there couldn't be a more incorrect statement. The truth is, words can hurt. They are very powerful when not used in the right way. You see, James 3:5 says, the tongue is a small thing, but what enormous damage it can do. How many of you know that to be true? Have you ever been the victim of the damage the tongue can do with mean words? Maybe someone has lied about you and it really hurt you. Or maybe you had a friend that talked about you behind your back and that destroyed your friendship. Perhaps you had someone make fun of you and put you down. That certainly causes damage to us, doesn't it? Well, let me share something with you. Sick words are a sign of a sick heart. Let me say that again. Sick words are a sign of a sick heart. There is good reason why we need to be careful when it comes to our words with friends. You see, when I was young, I used to go to the doctor and he would tell me to stick out my tongue and say, ah. Then he would look at my tongue and he would know whether or not if I was sick. I was always amazed by this. How can looking at the thing coming out of my mouth tell the doctor whether or not I'm sick? You know, boys and girls, it's the same way with our spiritual lives. A lot can be seen about what's going on in our hearts by simply looking at what's coming out of our mouth. It's true. The Bible says in Luke chapter 6, verse 45, whatever is in your heart determines what you say. That means if there are lies and bad words and cut downs and other mean words coming out of your mouth, then your heart is probably not filled with the things of God. Whatever it is in your heart will determine what you say. If your heart is filled with the things of God, good things will come out of your mouth. But if your heart is filled with sin, bad things are going to come out of your mouth. It's sad, but it's true. Today, we're going to use the word lift to learn 4 ways we can lift our words with friends from being low-level words that hurt others to high-level words that help others.
This time with 4 snowmen. Ooh, that was definitely a little trickier. Shout out the number if you think you know where the cookie is. Nice job. Now, let's try it again, but a little faster.
Helpless, you had won the victory before I.
So using the word lift, we're gonna start with the letter L, and that is look for good in others and say it. If you want to lift your words, one of the best ways is to look for the good in others and say it. Everybody loves when someone says nice things to them. Too many people look for the bad in others and they say it. Everyone hates that, don't they? If you want to lift your words, then look for the good in others. But just don't look for it. Once you find it, you gotta say it. When someone does well in class, tell them they did well. When someone treats you well as a friend, say it to them. When someone is a good singer or a good athlete or a strong witness for Jesus, say it with me, say it. Wherever you go, whoever you are around, look for the good in them and tell them what you see.
Okay, that was really tough. Did you keep your eye on the cookie? If so, shout it out. 1, 2, 3, or 4. Way to go. That was really challenging.
So, up next is I. Instead of blowing up, hush up. Too often, it is our angry words that do the most damage. Our friend makes us mad, then we blow up and say a bunch of mean things to them. That does a lot of damage. Instead of blowing up and losing control when someone makes you angry, keep your mouth closed. Most of the time when we allow angry words to fly out of our mouth, it doesn't end up lifting anyone. It tears them down. So when you are angry, close your mouth and count to 10. Don't let yourself speak to someone when you are angry.
Are you ready to get powered up with another power verse?
I know I am. Here we go. Today's power verse says, let everything you say be good and helpful, so that your words will be an encouragement to those who hear them. Ephesians 4:29. Wow! What a great power verse. It's got me all pumped. You know what that means? I want my girls to stand up and say it out loud with me. Come on, ladies, stand up and say the power verse with me, Tara Byte, on the count of three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Let everything you say be good and helpful, so that your words will be an encouragement to those who hear them. Ephesians 4:29. Nicely done, girls. You can sit back down. Now it's the boys' turn. I need all the boys to stand up and say the power verse with me on the count of three. Come on, guys. Nice and loud. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Let everything you say be good and helpful, so that your words will be an encouragement to those who hear them. Ephesians 4:29. Today, our power verse is all about the power of words. Seriously, you guys, words have so much power. And I don't mean like,
abracadabra, you're now a giraffe.
I'm talking about the words you use every day. Our words have the power to either cut people down or build them up. So we need to be like Jesus and use our words for the power of good. Now that you know that, let's get powered up and say the power verse together. Everybody stand up and say the power verse with me on the count of three. Here we go, everybody. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Let everything you say be good and helpful, so that your words will be an encouragement to those who hear them. Ephesians 4:29. Great job, everybody! You can sit back down now. I've gotta go, but I'll see you next time with another awesome power verse. This is Terabyte, signing off. Game on!
What happens if we add in one more snowman? All right, who knows where the cookie is at? Shout it out if you know it. Nice job! Now, can you do it if the snowmen go even faster?
F, fix the damage you have caused. If you're here today and you realize that many of your words with friends in the past have hurt others, it's time to fix it. You can't just change and hope everything will be all right. You have to go to the person you have hurt, and with your words, you tell them that you are sorry. Fix the damage you have caused, and let them know that you will choose to use your words to lift them up from now on.
Mercy, never forsaking me. Oh.
final letter in lift is the T. Tell the truth. Say it with me. Tell the truth. There is nothing worse than using your words with friends to lie to them. We must lift our words by choosing to tell the truth. No matter what, boys and girls, tell the truth. Even if it will mean you get in trouble for something you did, or tell the truth. You see, in Zechariah chapter 8, verse 16, it says this, speak the truth to each other. It's very important that we lift our words above the lies. No matter how hard it is, tell the truth. Even if you might get in trouble, tell the truth. Even if it means you won't get something you wanted, tell the truth. No matter what, say it with me, tell the truth. Lies are the opposite of what God is all about. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. God wants His children to tell the truth at all times. You know, one of the best ways to lift your words is to choose to speak the truth. You know, in the book of James chapter 3, verse 6, it says, and the tongue is a flame of fire. It is full of wickedness that can turn the entire course of your life into a blazing flame of destruction. Whoa, I mean, that's serious. Kids, I would love to be able to control your tongue and your words with friends for you, but I can't. Neither can your parents, neither can your teachers. The only one that can keep you from hurting others with your words is you. With God's help, you can lift your words with friends, and you can choose to use your words to help others and to build them up instead of hurting others and tearing them down. Can I pray for you right now? I ask that you would close your eyes and bow your heads. Heavenly Father, we come before you right now, and I ask for those kids, those boys and the girls that are watching this, Lord, that are having a hard time lifting their words to others. I pray right now that you will show them how they can use their words to help others instead of hurting others. Lord, I pray that you'll help the boys and girls to come up with ways that they can use their words with friends the right way, Lord, to give them compliments, to tell them the truth, to tell them someone about Jesus, Lord, to tell them about you, I pray. Lord, I pray right now that we would this year, in a new year, Lord, we would take control of this thing with your strength and that you will lead us and guide us, Father, so that we can encourage and bless someone, Father, instead of breaking them down. It is for your glory and for your honor we ask and pray these things. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen.
Learning to control our words with friends is one of the hardest lessons we can learn. We should use our words for helping others instead of hurting them, for telling the truth instead of lies, and for sharing the gospel instead of spreading gossip. Remember today's good to know. I will use my words to help, not hurt. Boys and girls, that is a huge lesson. Let's use our words to help people this week. And we will see you next time at the Hour of Power.
Faster. Okay, that was just crazy. Does anybody know where the cookie is? Wow! Anybody who could keep their eye on that snowman must really love gingerbread cookies. Great job, everyone.